office gossips may sound like a huge source of entertainment, and they are quite engaging too. I agree. But if not done consciously, those little chit-chats can turn your reality into nightmares. Today, towards the end of this video, I'll share a real example that happened in one of the company I was working for, where a casual chit-chat with a friend turned into a regret of lifetime. The first thing and very common which impact mostly every one of us in office, if we choose to disclose our personal stuff, our personal issues to others, is that we become victim of something called as loop effect or chain effect. This mistake impacts your image and your perceived worth inside the company in a very negative way. For example, you have 2-3 friends inside your office whom you consider really close to yourself, and one fine day when you were really upset about something back at your home or in your office, you disclosed those issues to them, you happen to speak to them about those issues individually, not in a group, and to every one of them you told that, hey, please don't tell this to anybody for obvious reasons. That information can be related to your personal issues, like relationship issues with your partner, relationship issues of your parents, financial issues of your family or yourself, or your professional issues with your manager or some stakeholder that you're working with inside the company and with whom you are not getting along so well. So now, after talking to 2-3 of them, you felt really light and you are back to your desk working hard on your stuff. So what happens in the background is these 2-3 friends have further people inside the company whom they are very close with. So while their usual chit chat, they happen to disclose your stuff to them, and the chain goes on. Before you realize, everybody in the company knows about your personal stories, your issues with your family or issues with your manager, and even your manager himself gets that download from somebody or other. Remember, your friends have not done it intentionally to hurt you, but it is outcome of something called as human nature. They either did it out of concern, they wanted to share the pain with somebody else, or they just did it as a chit-chat update with somebody. So now, what's wrong with this? How it will impact your growth or your image in a negative way? The biggest drawback of this loop effect is you will be judged for everything for no reason. You will be judged for being sick, you will be judged for being late to the office, you will be judged if you are not able to complete any task on time. Everything will somehow boil down to those rumors which your manager have heard from somebody else. Now let's understand the impact step by step on your growth. If there is a challenging project coming in, you getting assigned to that project is very unlikely, because your manager has got all that download from everybody else about you. So he will have that assumption in his head that you have so many issues back at home or issues with the stakeholder inside the company, so you'll not be able to coordinate well, you'll not be able to deliver as per the expectations, so it's better to assign somebody else who can perform. Another one, if you fail to complete a task or assignment on the given time because of some external issues can be related to the stakeholders that you are in conversation with, they didn't respond on time, or you had dependency on other resources which in turn made you wait and it resulted into a delay, for sure your manager will assume that though there were challenges externally, but majority of it is because you are disturbed personally, you have a lot of issues in your home or professionally. So no matter what the actual reason is, your manager will have this voice constantly telling him it's because of your personal issues. Third one, if there is a promotion on the way, it's very likely that somebody else will be considered for it, because your manager, basis the background that he has got about you, will assume that you are busy chit-chatting with everybody about your personal issues and you are so disturbed that you will not be able to take up responsibilities that come up with that next level. And also, people don't like to see such employees on higher position who has very poor self-hold. So people will perceive you as a very weak and timid person, and that's not a very great thing to be known for. So now it's time to share the real life example that happened in one of the companies that I was working for. So there were these two employees, very good friends, in the same team, in the same project, under same manager. So let's call them Ravi and Ankit for the sake of this example, though the real names were different. So one day while having their casual morning coffee in office, they were discussing about the IT industry and how the jobs are going around, how bad is the job market. So during that conversation, very casually, Ravi just shared with Ankit that, you know what, I think our jobs are good. I mean, we reach office at 9 and we leave by 5. It's working out fine. We get time for family as well. So I think it's okay. It's better than night shifts. So he went on talking casually, and Ankit also agreed to most of the stuff he says. And they finished that coffee, they went back to their work and the schedule took over. After a week or so, their manager happened to get a new project for the team, and it was a really good client, but the timing for that project would be around from 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. So he wanted to check with Ravi, because it has been long for Ravi that he was working within the same project. So he wanted to check with him if he is interested in that project. So what happens that day, Ravi was on leave and Ankit told him, you know what, I don't think so he'll be interested, because he likes the timing of his current project, because of which he is able to spend time with his family as well. So I don't think so he'll be considering this project. Why don't you consider somebody else? Ankit told to the manager. So manager went ahead and assigned a new resource who just joined their team to that project, and all the systems were updated accordingly. He got the client ID and everything was set up in that day. So next day when Ravi came and realized that, he was really upset. He was really upset with the manager that how can he do that with him? How can he not ask him or consider him for that new project? It's been long. He was so furious that he didn't even consider talking to his manager once. He straight away walked up to the HR team. He gave the whole download of the story to me. I also felt that that's unfair. His manager should have asked him once or should have considered him once. It's been long that he's working on that project. So while telling me the whole story, he told me that, you know what, even the timing 2 to 10 p.m. works so best for him, because he has a little kid at home and his wife is on early shift. And if he gets this 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. shift, for both of them, it will be really easy to manage their newborn kid. So I was like, that's okay, that's like icing on the cake. So I told him, I'll speak to your manager and see what can be done now. So he went off to his desk, and later that evening I met his manager, and his manager was shocked. His manager was shocked to know that Ravi walked up to the HR to share some concern. Because he told me, Varsha, Ravi was my first preference, and that day he was on leave when I was kind of looking for him. And because Ankit is so close to him, they are kind of best friends, they take every decision together. I assume that whatever Ankit told me about Ravi's preference is true, and I went by that. I was speechless myself. Then we called Ravi and Ankit inside the room, and Ankit narrated the whole story that Ravi only told him what his preferences are, that he hated a night shift and he always preferred 9-to-5 job. And Ravi argued with him like crazy. That's not what he meant. He was referring to night shifts. 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. is completely okay with him and even better than 9-to-5. From there on, Ravi and Ankit parted their ways. They were not seen together as much as they were seen earlier, and we couldn't assign that project to Ravi because so many formalities were already completed with that new employee onto the client side, and that client was little difficult, was not okay with making any ad hoc changes or so many changes. So he remained as is in that project. Did you see how a small conversation, how a small gesture or expression of your views casually can turn into a nightmare? So whatever you speak, whatever you say, be very conscious about that. You never know which statement of yours will reach your manager or reach somebody who is a decision maker, and it will impact your task and assignments, which in turn will impact your growth. Let me know in the comment section down below if you ever happen to be a victim of such things or such scenarios where office gossips impacted your growth in a certain way, so others can learn from those examples. That brings me to the end of this video, guys. I hope you find it useful. I'll bring more such content in my upcoming videos. Till then, stay blessed and happy. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.